So what we did is we made a project in Python where we basically take any file and translate it into any language that the user wants. So, alright, so basically we decided to go with Python in each project because it's much easier to debug many different errors. The syntax like for the language is much easier to understand, and you're able to import many different modules that you want to use. For example, we use the Google Translate API. So the Google Translate API like helps us import many different languages like possible that Google Translate even uses. So with that, the user can select many different options of languages that they want to convert the text into, and with the code, they're able to translate into that.
To also to emphasize, to help ease the pain for the user, we put all the languages in a four-in-a-line format. So we had four language and language code, I guess you could say, items in a line.
Yeah, so
tidy it up.
Yeah, basically, like, it's just much easier to, like, input different keywords so that, like, they don't have to type in the, like, exact language. They can just say, like, any, like, a two-letter, like,
two-letter
word.
Yeah.
So our objective, like we said earlier, is to create a program where anyone can input any file and input the specific language that they require or they need, and the program would be able to output the file in that certain language. So many uses for this like type of program would be like many different communications. Like for example, you have an office in like San Francisco and you like want to send a file to someone in India or in China or like in Europe, and they can't understand the language like that the PDF is in. So you can use this program to convert it into the language that you need so that it'd be easier for them to understand. And like our code was using the Google Translate API, like in all the different modules, and we were able to use like pip installs to like help us install everything much easier and much faster.
Mm-hmm.
So we can show the code itself.
And Google Cloud to get the API. What we do is we assign translate client as a variable, as a placeholder for a command so that we don't have to keep typing it out. And we also have results to just, basically we just assign variables. And in, the highlighted this thing. What we did here was, this is the part where we listed out all the language and the language codes so the user could figure out what code they wanted to use. And if we scroll down, this is where we asked them to input what the file, and also ask them to include the file extension so we could check which file it is. As of now, we only have PDFs, but we're working on it, so yeah. And
we can have TXT, like
TXT,
XML,
RTF, docs. So.
Or doc files in themselves, so.
And this is the part where we translate it. So the PDF part, we have a variable called ptext, where it extracts the text, and where you print, so basically it just prints out what the PDF's contents, and then, over here, in the last bit, we translate ptext into the language that the user desires it to be in. So that's basically the gist of the code.
Yeah, so
and
we can run it in.
Yeah.
So you're basically just calling the Google Translate API through this interface.
Yes.
Yes.
So it has all the things, and we have a sample
PDF.
Simple PDF. And then if we put like, let's say Russian, which is RU, it translates
to
Russian. And yeah.
How do you know this, Kari?
Well, we can type that into actual translate.
We can type that into, Google.
Type that into the PDF.
Yeah, there you go. Then you get the original English back.
Yeah.
That's a good point, yes. Good, good, very good.
Very nice.
Fantastic.
Good job.
Really, really good.
Thank you.
But my two cents is don't use Rashid as an example. Okay, use some other Chinese.
Well,
I mean,
sure,
he did.
Yeah, that's a joke. I mean, world is not.
Run it again.
Russian at the moment.
Yeah, it was just the first thing I
right.
saw.
So, but run it again. Show one more language.
Yeah, sure. We can do Spanish, like, because I understand Spanish, but.
Or Hindi or.
Yeah, anything.
Very impressive.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Does it save the result or not yet?
Not as of now, as of now, but later.
It's Spanish?
Yeah, you can see that.
You're like,
it's the same.
You may have some inconsistencies because, like, I've heard many times that you shouldn't use Google Translate for like full sentences because
yeah.
it's like a direct translation and sometimes that's not.
Because the thing is, like, like you would want
the grammar may not be correct.
Yeah, the grammar
yeah.
may not be correct. But
so like
think
that's
words,
okay.
If you translate something directly, like from English to like Spanish, like you won't, or like any language, it just won't like directly out.
No, the dependency
yeah.
is Google, which is fine. I mean, this is, so we are not getting into Kodak right now. So it's good. It's
yeah.
very good.
Good job. Nice.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Really good.